Hello everybody and welcome to the Shapr3D tutorial, how to use the visualization tool to explore color and material and finishes of a design. So we can turn a grayish looking toaster like this more into something interesting like this. As you can see, in this video I will focus on different material associations, material color combinations, and then also show you a practical process how we can then also create very interesting product presentations. The file for this is going to be shared with you, so please feel free to download it. And with all that said, let's get going. Let me show you now how we can use the new visualization tool to explore color, material and finishes, and even explore design themes for this toaster. We'll first go to visualization. I will zoom out a little bit and I will work on the easiest material, which in this case are the 4 feet. I will scroll down and with the pencil or your finger, drag the matte synthetic rubber material to there. I scroll up, there you see there is the material. We can change, by the way, the color of this. Maybe not as black. Very good. Now, I will open the object overview, navigate to the feet folder and hide it. Now this is gone. What I can do now is, because I would like to apply the metal material to the body, simply, with the pencil, press and hold, drag and select all the bodies. Then I can go to change, scroll down, and go to where we have brushed steel. Drag this over, and there we are. Beautiful. Let's try how this looks with rough steel. You notice, by the way, when you drag the material onto it, Shapr gives you a preview. This is actually really nice. So this way we have all the objects selected and can apply this material to all at the same time. We can also do the same with the brushed aluminum. You will see there is a slight difference in the color of the material. Very nice. Good. This brushed material is visualized in a really beautiful way. We have smooth highlights, this really nice brushed element on it, rotating these curved bodies and observing how the highlights flow over it is really nice. Okay, then, now I would like to add to individual elements some materials. So I will use the glossy ABS and drag this onto the buttons. This way you see the material will be applied to all the faces of an object. If you would like to add a material to individual faces of an object, you can simply select the faces the same way how I do this here, and then we go to change and I will select aluminum. There we are. Now, I will do the same also with the main body. Rotate around, select then all the important faces, which would simulate that all this will be made out of the plastic material too. You have to be careful when you select the faces that you do not tap too fast. Because if you tap too fast, then you will select the whole object. I only want to select individual faces. There, look at that. That actually already looks pretty good. We can show the feet. There. Very nice. Talking about variations and exploring different material combinations or options, I left the visualizer. I will select the toaster folder, turn on copy, and move a copy 30 centimeters to the side. Then I will go back to visualization, hide the original toaster. There we are. And now we can, for example, explore a different approach. I will select everything one more time, and then I will give this a brushed aluminum material. Very good. In this case, now maybe these elements I would like to be colorized. And then with the quantity of a material you select, you can also draw attention to individual pieces. In this case here, now these small grip elements I will make red and glossy. And then for further detailing, I select individual faces of this design, which I think they could be really interesting if we give those a different material. There we are. Very good. We can go back and then hide the original piece and then take a look. And you can see how useful this actually is when you have the same object as a copy. And then we can give them, like in this case, opposite material combinations and simply explore how the body would work with different colors, different materials. And as you see, the process is very easy. At one point, we also have to create then a nice presentation graphic. So I decided that I will go with my original idea. I will go to a side view, and here I draw a small rectangle right under it and revolve this. There we are. Make this a little bit bigger. This sketch I can delete. I do not need this anymore. And I will give this a default material, which it has. And then when I select the individual faces, top and the side, I can give this complementary or the same colors. Careful a bit with the type of color you select. Now with RGB, we have, when we visualize something, we need to be careful that we also use colors which can be manufactured. And I will select here white, because this is a really nice contrast. You see already the way how the object is positioned. The light is coming from the upper left corner. So the shadow goes to the lower right corner, which when I put this product into a presentation like this, the light comes from the left, the shadow goes to the right. That is perfect. That's kind of like the way how I would like this to be. Now, to further adjust our environment, we can give this a basic color. For example, white, or also here a contrast color, or something really black. It's up to you to decide. A gradient will actually look really nice too. And then when we go to views, we can go to top view, upper left corner, capture then a view, go to the back view. Now, if I would make this capture this view, you will see that we have this filled background. If I do not want this to be there for that moment, I can set this to transparent and then go back to the gradient. What is really nice to do with product presentations is also when we explore camera angle or the lens. So I will go to parents. And when I set this to a really low value, you can see that the three-dimensional object starts at one point to look really like a an orthographic two-dimensional drawing, which is quite nice if you want to minimize the amount of perspective for shortening. And then with my one finger, I adjust the rotation or the camera angle, and then with two fingers, I can move this up and down. To make this a much more dramatic view, I will go a little bit to here. And then can zoom in a little bit. And with one finger, I rotate the view, pay attention to how do the feet and the shadow on the ground line up. Maybe this angle is a tick too much. Can go like really excessive too. Rotate the view a little bit again. There we are. Zoom in. And then we can create a capture. And this is basically the process then how you can create kind of like technical looking orthographic presentations of your design, including the visualized materials, and more dramatic looking, exciting presentations of the product. I hope this video was informative. And that's it. Bye bye.